Good morning. Myself, Dr. R.K. Mangal from Department of Physics, Jaipur Engineering College and Research Center, Tonk Road, Jaipur. Today, we are going to discuss Maxwell's equations, which are under the topic electromagnetism. Maxwell's equations are four. Since Faraday showed that the electric field is produced by changing magnetic field, James Clerk Maxwell introduced a concept that the magnetic field can be produced by changing electric field. So, to explain electric and magnetic fields or electromagnetics, Maxwell gave some basic equations called Maxwell's equations. These equations are Gauss's law for electric field, Gauss's law for magnetic field, Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction, and Ampere's circuital law. Maxwell's first equation is based on Gauss's law for electric field. According to this law, total electric flux passing through a closed surface S in vacuum is equal to the product of total charge Q contained inside and 1 upon epsilon naught. That is, phi E is equal to surface integration for a closed surface E dot dA barabar Q upon epsilon 0. But for a medium, epsilon E barabar integration for a closed surface E dot dA barabar Q upon epsilon. If charge inside the closed surface is continuously distributed and rho is charge volume density, then we can write Q is equal to volume integration rho dV. From equation 1 and 2, integration for a closed surface E dot dA barabar 1 upon epsilon volume integration rho dV. Equation number 3 is known as integral form of Maxwell's first equation. Using Gauss divergence theorem, surface integration for a closed surface E dot dA barabar volume integration del dot E into dV. So equation 3 can be written as volume integration del dot E into dV barabar 1 upon epsilon volume integration rho dV. It means del dot E barabar rho upon epsilon, or divergence E barabar rho upon epsilon, equation number 4. Equation number 4 is differential form of Maxwell's first equation. If medium is homogeneous and isotopic, then del dot epsilon E is equal to rho. It means del dot D barabar rho, where D barabar epsilon E is known as displacement vector. But for a free space, rho is equal to J is equal to 0, then Maxwell's first equation becomes surface integration for a closed surface E dot dA barabar 0. It means del dot E barabar 0 or del dot D barabar 0. Maxwell's second equation is based on Gauss's law for magnetic field. According to the law, net outgoing magnetic flux from any surface is always 0. This is due to fact that magnetic field lines always from closed loop. That is, phi B barabar 0, or it may be written as surface integration B dot dA barabar 0. That is equation number 5. Equation number 5 is integral form of Maxwell's second equation. Using Gauss's divergence theorem, surface integration V dot dA barabar volume integration divergence B into dV. It means divergence B barabar 0 or del dot B barabar 0. Equation number 6. This is differential form of Maxwell's second equation. This equation proves theoretically that magnetic monopoles does not exist in nature. Maxwell's third equation is based on Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction. According to this law, whenever magnetic flux linked with a circuit changes, an electromotive force is induced in the circuit, and this induced EMF is directly proportional to the rate of change of magnetic flux linked with the circuit. According to Lenz's law, its direction is always opposite to the changes responsible for its production. That is, E is equal to minus del phi B upon del T. Since line integral of electric field is also equal to the EMF. That is, E is equal to closed loop integration E dot dr. And we know that magnetic flux del phi barabar surface integration for a closed surface B dot dA. So closed loop integration E dot dr barabar minus del upon del T surface integration for a closed surface B dot dA. Or closed loop integration E dot dr barabar minus surface integration for a closed surface del B upon del T dot dA. Equation number 7 is known as integral form of Maxwell's third equation. Using Stokes curl theorem, closed loop integration E dot dr barabar surface integration for a closed surface del cross E dot dA. So surface integration for a closed loop surface del cross E dot dA barabar minus surface integration del V upon del T dot dA. It means del cross E barabar minus del V upon del T or curl E barabar minus del V upon del T. This is equation number 8. Equation number 8 is differential form of Maxwell's third equation. For static fields with respect to time, that is for del V upon del T barabar 0 barabar del E upon del T. It means del cross E barabar 0 or surface integration for a closed surface E dot dr barabar 0. Right? Maxwell's fourth equation is based on Ampere's circuital law. According to this law, line integral of magnetic field over a closed path is equal to mu times the net current passes through the closed path. That is, closed loop integration B dot dr barabar mu summation of I. If current density is J, then summation of I barabar surface integration for a closed surface J dot dA. So closed loop integration B dot dr barabar mu times surface integration for a closed surface J dot dA. This is equation number 9. From Stokes curl theorem, closed loop integration B dot dr barabar surface integration for a closed surface del cross B dot dA. This is equation number 10. On comparing equation number 9 and 10, we get del cross B barabar mu J. It means curl of vector B barabar mu J. Equation number 11. But there is an inconsistency in this law. As taking divergence both sides of this equation, we get del dot del cross B barabar mu del dot J. But we know that divergence of curl of a vector is always zero. That is, del dot del cross B barabar zero. It means del dot J barabar zero. This is equation number 12. But from continuity equation, del dot J plus del rho upon del T barabar zero. This is equation number 13. On comparing equation 12 and 13, we can say that Ampere's law is valid only for steady currents. That is, for which rho is equal to zero or constant, such that del rho upon del T barabar zero. Maxwell removed this inconsistency by giving a suggestion that total current density J can be considered as made of two types of currents. Free current density JF, which comes from motion of free charges, and displacement current density JD, which comes from the change in electric field with respect to time. It means J barabar JF plus JD means sum of free current density and displacement current density. Equation number 11 now becomes del cross B barabar mu JF plus JD. Again, taking divergence both sides, we get del dot del cross B barabar mu del dot JF plus del dot JD. Del dot JF plus del dot JD barabar 0, it means del dot JD barabar minus del dot JF. Equation number 14. But from continuity equation, del dot JF plus del rho upon del T barabar 0 or del dot JF barabar minus del rho upon del T. This is equation number 15. On comparing equation number 14 and 15, we have del dot JD barabar del rho upon del T. Del dot JD barabar del upon del T bracket del dot D. Using Maxwell equation, we can write rho as del dot JD. So JD barabar del D upon del T. After Maxwell's modification, equation 9 becomes closed loop integration B dot dr barabar mu surface integration for a closed surface JF plus JD dot dA. So closed loop integration B dot dr barabar mu surface integration for a closed surface JF plus del D upon del T dot dA. Equation number 16 is integral form of Maxwell's fourth equation. Using Stokes' curl theorem, closed loop integration B dot dr barabar surface integration del cross B dot dA. So equation 16 becomes surface integration for a closed surface del cross B dot dA barabar mu times surface integration JF plus del D upon del T dot dA. It means del cross B barabar mu times JF plus del D upon del T or del dot B barabar mu JF plus mu epsilon del E upon del T. Equation number 17 is differential form of Maxwell's fourth equation. This is the generalized form of Maxwell's equation given in the table where serial number 1, serial number 2, 3 and 4 shows differential and integral form of Maxwell equation number 1, 2, 3 and 4, which are Gauss's law for electrostatics and Gauss's law for magnetostatics, Faraday's law and Ampere's law. Thank you. If there are any queries, kindly ask me. I will provide my details for you on request. Thank you.